All right, this is the Bloomberg Opinion. It says, all aboard the billionaires Bitcoin bandwagon. And we've seen these billionaires come out of the woodwork. Alex just talked about one today. And now we know that other big entities have been investing into Bitcoin a long time ago. Guggenheim being one of them, who is buying up Bitcoin at $10,000. So it's a nice little piece where it talks about the super rich can afford to dabble in crypto. Mere financial mortals, not so much. So there's two sides of this story, and I'm not going to get into any of it, really. Not in this piece. I'm going to show you exactly what I'm talking about. I just want to go over this first paragraph. It says, now that Bitcoin has topped 20 grand for the first time, should you shift your hard-earned cash into digital currencies? History suggests caution should be your watchword, no matter how strong the fear of missing out may be. And it goes over some different pieces, and some are just kind of ridiculous. So let's just break into what we know and the charts. I'm not a big TA person, as you may have known, but I do like to look back at the past. And one of the patterns that I definitely see is this. Halving, all-time high, dip, space. Halving, all-time high, dip, space. Halving, 2020, all-time high, 2021. Dip, 2022, space, or a rebound, 2023. And it starts the whole process over and over and over again. So let me break that down and tell you exactly what I'm going to do as far as my dollar cost averaging, because there is a point where I'm going to have to stop. This is the conservative Bitcoin price prediction. I just took a look at the first, second, and third halvings, and the price increased on each one. So the first halving was in November 2012, and then when it reached its all-time high, it was December 2013, so about a year. The day of the halving was November 2012, and it was $12. A year later, it was $1,000. That is an increase by about 8,000%. All makes sense so far. Great. The second halving happened in July 2016. It hit its all-time high about a year and a half later on December 2017. So when it was actually a halving, it was $650, and it went up to $20,000, which was on December 2017. So there's two ways to look at it. The percentage increase, it was 8,000%, then it went down to 3,000%. So about two-thirds actually it went down, or a third of this, a third of 8,000 roughly is around 2,900. Another way to look at it is the all-time high was about 1,000, then it went up to 20,000, that's about 20x. Now the third halving, that just happened in May 2020. When's the next all-time high? I have no idea. But I'm guessing maybe 2022, maybe 2021, not for sure. But if we take a look at this, 1 year to a year and a half to 2 years, that could possibly be what it is. What was the price of the halving? $10,000. So we want to look at increases, 8,000 to 3,000, decrease this by about two-thirds, you're going to get about 1,000%. So at 10,000 times 1,000%, you get about $100,000. This is why I give my prediction of 150,000, because I just want to be right in the middle. About 150,000 is where I see the next all-time high. And that's a very conservative number. Now let's do this. I call this one the Draper. Draper thinks it's going to be around 250 to 300,000, somewhere around there. So the same numbers are true. The only difference is that instead of decreasing by about two thirds or a third from, 8,000 to 3,000, it's still the same. But let's say we went from 3,000 and we shot up by about a third to a half. We'd get about a 4,500% increase. If the numbers are 10,000 times 4,500% increase, we get around 450,000. 450,000. That's where Draper's somewhere around there. Okay. Then if we go off on the deep end, I call this the McAfee, which is just crazy, I think. You get this, and then, or the one way, you go the opposite way. You get 10,000%, 10,000 times 10,000%, $1 million. And these are all numbers. You're like, well, no big deal. Let's just hit to a million. Not a thing. Well, wait. Here's the market cap calculator. Let's just break this down. The circulating supply is about 18.5. I think it's actually much lower than that because people have thrown away their Bitcoin, but whatever. They're always going to stick to 18.5. Maybe in a year it's going to be 19 million. Not for sure because they're going to mine some more Bitcoin. Sure, let's just stick with 18.5 to make things nice and easy. So if we get 100,000, that means the market cap's almost 2 trillion. I can see 2 trillion. Makes sense, right? How about 150,000? We're looking at almost 3 trillion. 3 trillion? Okay. We're kind of pushing some edges, but I'm sure we can do it. We almost hit a trillion last time. I'm sure we could triple that. Now I want to show you the Draper. Let's do 450,000. You're looking at $8.3 trillion. Could we do that? I don't know, maybe. But I will just tell you this. The total supply of gold, which has been around for thousands of years, is about 11 to 12 trillion. So we would be 3/4 of everything that's in gold right now. Okay, maybe. So let's go for a million. Let's just see what happens here. You're looking at $18.5 trillion. So you've almost doubled the amount of gold. You've got some other things, maybe in derivatives. You maybe have gobbled up some real estate and tokenized something else. You've done a lot of things and you put a lot of money into it. Could this happen? I don't see it. I just don't see it. And maybe it could. I don't see it in this cycle. But I will tell you this, Bitcoin will do extremely well. I know it. I feel it. I've been talking about it for the last year on this channel. Do I see it's going to go up that much? I hope it does. But I just don't see it right now, especially not in a year or less. This leads me to my very last point, dollar cost averaging. And I got this question a lot because one of my price points was $19,900 for Bitcoin to sell off just a little bit and take some profits. And the question was, well, are you going to dollar cost average because you're taking profits? So what's the point of that? Really comes down to this. What is the price point of where Bitcoin will retract to? That's the big question. So again, we have to look at the past. So the first halving was in 2012. This was the all-time high a year later. What I want to know is what was this low point from the actual high point between the first and second halving? Meaning, we know it was around $1,000, right? It was $1,000, $994 on 2013, which is right around here, $1,000. What was the low point right here? Well, to do that, I need to find out all the times and all the dates between 2013 and 2016, between the first and second halving, or 2012 and 2016. Because I need to find this low point right here to see what that number is. So here we are. I'll take this graph. The very lowest point that I can see, this is 210. This is 172. Let's work with round numbers. Let's say about $200. So it went from $1,000 to the high, and it dropped down to almost $200 in January 2015. That is 20% of the all-time high. So what happened after here, after the second halving? Going back, it was $20,000. I didn't find out from the all-time high, which is right around, well, which was December 2017, what was the lowest point between then and now? Because I want to find how much it dipped from the all-time high. Just bring up CoinGecko again. Here it is from 2017 all the way to today. The lowest point that I can see, I thought it was actually in March at $5,300, but it wasn't. We have to go all the way back over here. It was $3,378. Let's work with round numbers. Let's say it's around $4,000. Let's just round up, which is a heck of a roundup, let's be honest. But let's say $4,000. It was at $20,000, went down to $4,000. What is that? 20%. So just like the first episode, we went from $1,000 to $200. That's 20%. The next episode went from $20,000 to $4,000. That's 20%. What's going to happen in the future? I don't know, but I have to take a look at the past and go, well, if we hit $150,000, what is 20% of $150,000? $30,000. I believe, and I could be wrong, I hope I'm wrong, I believe after $30,000, I'm going to stop dollar cost averaging. Because after that, it's going to go all the way up and come all the way back down. So right now, I'm still going to be dollar cost averaging. I'm putting a little bit less into Bitcoin because I think it's still going to be a little bit more of a correction. But past $30,000, I cannot put anything in until it drives all the way up to $150,000, somewhere around there. And I believe it'll go all the way back to $30,000 based on the history. Now, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And I'll be okay with that because I've been doing the hard work just like you've been doing the hard work. Over this whole time, from all the way here, all the way to here, me and you have been doing dollar cost averaging, especially if you listen to this channel. That's all I talk about. I've been putting in money just little bits here, and not just on Bitcoin, everything in my portfolio, from this for this and this and this and this, even here and even here. It was hard. It wasn't easy, but you got to be disciplined. And after I was done, I was like, did I do the right thing? Did I do the right thing? I think I did. I know I did. And here we are. So, all right. So look, I know that's a bit long. I apologize, but I think a lot of those questions needed to be answered. I just wanted you to be careful. That's all. Again, take predictions with a grain of salt. Nobody's got a crystal ball, but I think we all know where this is going. There's a lot of institutional players in there. We know that they are going to help us stabilize the price point because they're not going anywhere. If they have the same philosophy as Michael Saylor, they're not selling. They're just accumulating. So we'll see what happens. I think you'll see some pullbacks, you'll see some FUD, you'll see some bad news. But again, 2021, I don't think we can lose here. I think it's going to be fireworks. All right, so that's it. So thanks for sticking with me through the whole thing. I really appreciate it. If you like these types of videos, there's going to be two more that's going to pop up on your left and right. Not sure I'll let YouTube do its magic. And that's all she wrote. So thanks again, and I'll see you on the next one.